So let us continue with the discussion of cooperatives. There's something called primary cooperative credit societies. They are formed at village or town level. Again, all these are not really required for you for general banking interview, only if you're for RDO. Just for information, we are providing here, okay? So this cooperative societies other than PACS, okay? PACS is primary agricultural credit society. So a group of people from same locality will form an association and contribute funds, okay? These funds can also be obtained from central cooperative banks. And they lend to small, usually to small loans or for farm input, seeds, fertilizers, etc. Okay. And as you said, the share capital will be less than 1 lakh. These societies do not require RBI license, but RBI has some regulatory powers. So the question is, what is ceiling of paid up capital for primary credit society is 1 lakh. Then there is something called PACS, Primary Agricultural Credit Society. It's an agricultural credit society that can be started with 10 or more persons, usually from the same village. The members will have unlimited liability. So in case the society fails, the members are responsible for the entire loss of society. Then the loans are usually given for short period, for the harvest season, for carrying on agricultural operations. They depend mostly on the central cooperative banks for funds. Okay? They have some problems. PACS, that are PACS, the Primary Agricultural Credit Society, also known as PACS, have some problems, like they have low resource base, poor recoveries, lack of business diversification, huge losses, lack of professionalism in the management, lack of skilled manpower, and poor systems. So you just remember that what are the disadvantages of PACS, that will be sufficient for this chapter. Then the central cooperative banks, these are federations of primary credit societies in a specified area. So normally in a district, all the primary credit societies come under the umbrella of central cooperative banks. Okay. So for these banks, the four sources of funds will be their own share capital, they take deposits from public, and also loans from state cooperative banks. So they lend to village primary societies, and they in turn lend to the members. They also undertake normal commercial banking activities like deposits and lending. So the questions need to be prepared are, what are central cooperative banks and what are the sources of funds for central cooperative banks? Then there are district cooperative banks. This is a district central bank for every district in the state. Okay, it is known in that by the name of the respective district cooperative central bank. Okay, the members and their elected directors who represent, they come from a variety of backgrounds, like for example milk unions, cooperatives, okay, and various other people. They'll send the representatives here, and these banks are collectively represented by a state apex central cooperative bank for each state, okay, and it acts as the ultimate bank at the apex body for the DCCs under each state. And what we usually observe is the local politicians will hold a tremendous influence on these cooperatives and get elected as the president of the DCC bank. Okay, so just remember, what is a DCC bank, that is a district cooperative central bank, and what is the apex body for all district central cooperative banks under each state. Then there are state cooperative banks. This is the apex of the cooperative credit structure in each state. So for the entire state, there will be one apex body, state cooperative bank. What they do, they coordinate the and control the working of central cooperative banks in each state. Their funds are share capital, deposit from public, and RBI will give them loans and advances. Okay, so just remember the questions, what are the state cooperative banks and what are the sources of funds for state cooperative banks. So long-term cooperative credit is one topic we didn't discuss here. So the apex level organization of agriculture and rural development banks here is the National Cooperative Agriculture and Rural Development Banks Federation. The long-term cooperative credit structure consists of the STISC, we discussed SCARDBs, PCRDBs, which are affiliated to SCARDBs. So SCARDBs, source of funds are share capital, deposit and issue of bonds, and they mainly grant loans to on the security of agricultural properties. So the loans could be like redemption of old loans, purchase of land, improvement of land, agricultural equipment, sinking of wells, installation of pumps, etc. So the questions you need to be prepared in this chapter: what is the structure of long-term cooperative credit structure? What is full form of SCARDB? What are the sources of funds of SCARDB, and for what purposes do SCARDBs give loans?